Greetings, minions! I am your humble narrator, Uncle Sideways, and we've got another one of these. The Retainer of Power in Total War Warhammer 2. High Elves, you get it. Okay, the Retainer of Power. The Seneschal of the Court controls the flow of information to and from the Phoenix King. He is, therefore, an important figure with great power. It is discovered that the Seneschal has been choosing which information reaches the court in order to maintain his power and reduce that of others. It is a shrewd tactic, but courtiers are only as smart as the secrets they hide. Calm the fuck down. Once exposed, they are powerless. Okay, so we could dismiss the Seneschal and get the... I mean, we're definitely doing that one. Nah, there's no point in reading the other ones. Just definitely doing that one. Because again, 5%, like 5 public order reduction, that's perfectly fine. Look at this. Does this strike you as a place that is worried about public order? We live in Disneyland, mate. Disneyland. For right. Order. You know, I am gonna. Yeah. I wasn't sure if I was gonna fight that battle, but then I decided no, I'm definitely gonna fight that battle. If only because I guarantee you the game would be an absolute cock about it. Like, the game would somehow make me lose all of my fucking units to that if I didn't fight it. Do you know what I mean? Like, the game would be an asshole about that. Because this game is really good at being a colossal bellend. Like, I don't quite know why the game is so good at being a colossal bellend, but the game is good at being a colossal bellend about making you lose units, even when you really shouldn't. I don't know how they do the fucking maths, man. Sorry, I need to make a plan with a friend of mine later. Okay. That's dealt with. Right, here we go. Okay, what have we got? Well, we have got no frame rate. That's one thing we've got. We have got, yep, dick all frame rate. The frame rate has left. The frame rate has moved away. The frame rate just doesn't exist. Someone came in and sold the frame rate. You know what? Fuck it. Even if it doesn't make sense, I'm hiding them there anyway. Because I'm not bringing the fucking cavalry in. Not for this one. Understood. Nope. I was gonna stop that, but no. It actually makes total sense for those guys to be the. No, it doesn't. Okay, right. You out. You out. You in. You in. Alright. There you go. Force one. There you go. Force two. I'm not even going to. Actually. I was going to send you in, but I'm not. Not gonna. No point. There's no point. I'm not using the battering ram, because the battering ram opens me to their fucking cavalry, is all that battering ram will do. Right. Where the fuck? Fantastic. They've put their fucking Jesus. There we go, this will be fine. We've got precisely one tower to worry about. We'll do alright. We'll do alright. I mean, because if logic's anything, that fucking tower is going to be like almost... I think that tower will probably just be aiming at... I can't tell if it's aiming at the tower or my lord. I don't know. I am actually having trouble telling that right now. Not entirely sure. Right, just while they're, if they're just gonna stand there, might as well hit them with an explosion full of tree. And I actually hit him with a healing spell because he could deal with it, poor bastard. And there used to be a thing I do sometimes if I need, if I'm in a slightly dire health situation, is I'd literally just kind of, I'd let the battle last longer than it needed to, so I could just keep hitting my generals or my units with a lot of health stuff. Also, yeah, my computer is not happy with this this level or this map. Really not pleased. They will not withstand our fury. Spearmen for the Ever Queen. Right, so currently order must be maintained. Okay. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. Here's the very important thing we're going to do. We are, now that those guys have run, we are going to get up on the wall. Yeah, we're just going to get everyone up on the wall and just attack them from inside their own fucking base. Why not? There's literally no reason to do anything else. Literally, I have every single reason to just pepper them with shots from up here instead of actually engaging them. Okay, yeah, I think that's both units are, I just going up through the tower. And since they're doing that, let's just get our archers into a nice sniping position. Because quite simply, why the fuck not? If I can, why not? They just about managed that. Just about managed to avoid it. Beware, enemy fire. It will be done. Fuck it, I'm gonna go down and engage them. This seems unfair. It just seems mean to not go down and engage them, really. That's a question. Why isn't my actual unit going off the wall? Okay, now the actual unit's going off the wall. I was fucking wondering that. The actual unit was just fucking... The actual units are just running around the outside, not really getting involved. Yeah, shaken by faster and stronger enemies nearby. Yeah. It does baffle me that is actually a negative they suffer. That if there are stronger enemies nearby, they panic. Personally, I wouldn't put that in, because that just means you get even less use out of a relatively weak unit. You know what I mean? Because what that does is it means that fucking unit just means that an already, like, disadvantaged unit can't really do much. Right, back up on the wall. Prince above one. I agree. Yeah, fuck it. Just send guys up on the walls again. It's fine. It's perfectly fine. Okay, so they're all dead. Right. Now let's. It shall be done. This is like an absurd. This is an absurd way to deal with a siege. I want to make that absolutely clear, that I am fully aware that this is a ridiculous way to deal with a siege. Oh dear. Hang on, what the fuck are you doing? Get on the actual wall, dickhead. Don't stand on the floor. What the hell's wrong with you? I suppose it looks like they did actually run into the remnants of a fleeing force, and that's what. That's what stopped him. Is she on the wall yet? No, she's not. Get on the fucking wall, love. How Hanging out off of the wall is a problem. I mean, the archers are clever enough to not get off the wall, and then I turn around and see some running off the wall. No, I don't turn around and see some running around off of the wall. The archers are just clever enough to stay on the wall forever. Fuck it. They want to come down and get beaten up again? Fine. We will fucking have you. It's because they are just going to lose. Yeah, there's like barely any of you left. Stay down. Understood. Stay down, friend. Stay the fuck down. It's better for you to stay down than to fight again, friend. It just is. Okay, there we go. So for some reason, the fucking game had stopped responding to me. Okay. Right, well, I think, really, what we have to do at this stage is, yeah, I think what we have to, what we really, realistically have to do at this stage is, basically block him in, I think to do with them now. Block them in and just fucking poke them till they're dead. Because what's that? That's, yeah, it's like some Illyrian Reaver archers and Silver Helms. Yeah, we'll deal with it. Pop. I mean, that's great because the Silver Helms actually got in the way of that. Okay, so Helms, I was convinced you were going to, like, engage there? Instead of, yeah, good, do that. Actually engage with the force that's supposed to be, that you're supposed to be fighting, please. These guys are, like, not good at dealing with sieges. You know what I mean? These guys are not good at dealing with being besieged. Cool, good. That was, like, the weirdest. That was the weirdest siege. The weirdest. You can't really deal with a siege with horsemen, really. Because really, the only way you can deal with that, because this is actually an issue I sometimes have on the occasions I try and play Bretonnia, is the issue with being besieged as Bretonnia is that all of your best units are on horseback, which means the second the fuckers are actually on the walls, you've got a problem. Or the second they're in the city, you have a problem, because then you are, like, pretty easy to... It's pretty easy to, like, box you in. In cities, and you don't want cavalry being boxed in by spears. So you need to sally out with your cavalry. Fuck, you know. So I just caught the wire of my headphones there. Accidentally, they pulled the fucking speaker at me. Which would have been a problem. Would have been a serious problem. Yes, Ulf Juan Triumphant, Haru Haru and such.
We will not be held.
Yes, we will actually plunder this. I don't normally plunder, but for 2,000 gold, I'll get some plundering done. So yeah, that's war. That's... Yeah, yeah. That was one of the few times in which plunder is actually worth it.
Faithful servant.
A true one of the few occasions. So what do they have?
Defender of the Everqueen.
Ah, they just have a place where I can build horses. Build horses, fuck me. Okay.
Protector of Ulthuan.
That's enough, and I'll tell you what I'm gonna do.
Your bidding. Defender of the.
Probably a bit of a waste of money, but there we go. Wait a couple of turns, and then I'll be able to march out again. It'll be fantastic. Yes, give me points to make his army better. This is what I've decided I'm focusing on. With Jalen, I've decided I'm going to focus on, like, make him a red guy. Just make his units better. rather than trying to make him any better. And we're also actually going to give him his horse back. There we go. He'll be a happy chappy on his horsey horse. There we go. He'll be nice and pleased. Okay, what do we have in the shipwreck, lads? Dear Alistair, we have a pile of gold. Isn't that fabulous? What else? Okay, there's one there that, yeah, I'll start sending. I'll start sending him in that direction. That'll be fine. Actually, what I kind of want to do is, kind of want to almost basically let, because what am I getting out of here? I'm getting 200 gold, which is good, and a garrison, which, actually, how is that garrison looking? I'll take a decent garrison. I think that could, probably hold that off, honestly, that garrison. So, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to send Tyrion fucking sprinting back so I can improve his army. Basically, so I can get him some of them white lions in here. Yeah, get him some of them white lions. Where's the fucking building tab? There it is, right. Nah, I'm saving it up.
We have shaped this world.
Right, if I increase that, I get 50 more. If I increase that, I get an extra 300. Yeah, fuck it. Okay. that is worth it, as far as I'm concerned. That is just actually worth that price. It's a nice big kind of bump in our it's a nice big bump in our wealth there. And yeah, of course, the Kingdom of Saffrey. Immediately. Auto resolve. And Valiant Defeat, yeah. Whatever. I'm not fighting another fucking siege battle today. I've fought a lot of siege battles today. Unless it's like an important siege battle, I'm not fighting another siege battle today. That's my decision. Right now. Yeah, an ally finally mobilizes against that force. Thank fuck. Okay, so now, just like take a couple of steps over that. Yeah, over that border. Get rid of them. So we have four of those. Because now, I want 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 4. I'm sorry. Let's get one of you. How much do these silver helms cost? Okay, I won't invest in silver helms for him right now. But we are getting a lot of white lions of Shrace. So we can actually deal with other infantry. So we have something, because fucking, I have seen now the power of the white fucking lions, man. I've seen it now. Do you know what I mean? Fuck it, it's scary. It's fucking scary, mate. What these fuckers can do.
Dispatch me.
Okay, and next turn, Jalen's army will be back to top. Well, I genuinely just don't think that the guys in Vol's Anvil can really get any better. I don't think they can. And once Vol's Anvil has been taken, I can turn around and worry about the Kingdom of Saffrey and bring both of my armies to bear against them. And then we can focus on someone the fuck else. Than these two. Oh, Favor of the Phoenix. What we got here? Hang on a minute. Oh, no, wait, yeah, we're gonna be fucking losing money to the fucking White Lions. Of course we are. The courtiers align themselves before the court, all vying for royal attention and favor. Sycophantic, but necessary. The Ever Queen cares not for such pandering, and so the dispensation of favor falls to the Phoenix King. The Mages of Calador, the Horse Masters of Illyrian, and the Stalwart Defenders of Kothic all prostrate themselves before him, and he asks you whom he should favor. We're going to favor Kothic here, just because I could do with that bonus to melee defense. Just because we are shortly going to be walking dick first into a fight against... What garrison have they got? Not a great garrison, but it's more than I'd want. Actually, I'm
ever vigilant.
You know what I'm gonna do, actually. I'm gonna send Tyrion to deal with this.
Ready to march.
And I'm gonna fucking send him. I'm gonna start sending him back the other way.
I'm listening. What business have you with the Asur of Ulthuan?
You know, I'm not gonna get in a non-aggression pact with you because I'm probably gonna go to war with you. I'm probably gonna move into your place and start trying to steal your shit at some point in the near future. So there's not really much point in me agreeing and not fight you.
Protector.
Sorry, but it's true. Literally no point in lying to you like that, and it would be a lie to claim I wasn't going to cause as many problems for you as I physically could. Just speaking truth. Just speaking truth. Telling it like it is to the shiniest of boys.
The winds are mine.
Right there, yeah. You get to fuck out of the place. There we go. There.
Loyal to a
That's better. And we'll give her, increase her earth blood as well, I think. Yeah, that'd be good, Henta. And yes, you are going to be giving me some nice extra money, aren't you? Yes, you are, my friend. Yes, you are indeed. Slightly upsetting that I don't have a cheaper way to just kind of suddenly decide I'm getting more money.
Servant of the king. I am honored.
But such is life. And I'm sorry for trespassing, but that is a really awkward border. You have to admit, that is an incredibly awkward border there. I don't want to be trespassing, but I don't really have much choice. Shipwreck. Sunken chest, yes please. Ah, Sword of Bloodshed, okay. I was hoping for gold, but I'll take that.
Across the waves.
Oh, yeah, we got another shipwreck there that we can go check out. While Jalen is standing proudly. Thankfully, neither of our enemies are actually doing anything right now. They do literally just appear to be standing about, getting very little done. Sounds about right, if I'm being honest. Does sound about right. Okay, so that construction's complete, and yet somehow, apparently, my outgoing money has also equally jumped, so that I'm not actually making. So I'm not. There's no difference in how much money I've got. So that's fantastic. Hi. Yeah, I know you're saying that's the layout, but here's what's happening. In two turns, my white lions are climbing up your fucking walls. Soz. But that's what's gonna happen. Okay. I don't even know where the fuck has their army gone? Yeah, I actually don't know where their army's gone. Also, can I fucking get these pirates to fuck off? Nope, I cannot get those pirates to fuck off. I want those pirates to fuck off, but it looks like I cannot talk them into it just now. I also can't afford to get the glittering lighthouse, but can I fucking get some? Can I get some gold income here? There we go. That's like a small, it's like just a small like increase to my gold income. It's not a massive one, but it's enough that it'll fucking help this bastard shortfall I've got here. At least until I take Vol's Anvil, or if that has gold in it. I hope that has gold in it. Because I'm running out. I'm going to start suffering from fucking poverty attrition soon. Oh, war coordination target has been lost. hours out. Oh, hello. There we go. The would-be suitor, no offensive Illyrian. I've covered this one before. Take it as a consort. Yeah. I mean, I could have probably done with the Priestess of Isha buff there, honestly, but... Fell cargo. Okay, cool, cool. We got some more cash. Oh, good. 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 More stuff. It's what I want. Let's just go stand him over there. Oh, good. That's why. He's taken the White Tower. I mean, I am going to need to look to see how we actually go about... Because I'd assume you can go from Vassal to... given a fair hearing in the Phoenix Court. I'm going to give you a little prezi.
As you say.
Just so you don't get upset with me. How's my other Vassal doing?
You have a proposal for the Asur.
Yeah, you're not doing great. I'm probably going to have to fight you. Yeah, that I am probably going to have to fight you. But you guys, I don't want to have to fight you. Honestly, if I could get away with it, I wouldn't fight you. If I felt like that was viable, I wouldn't start a punch up with you because I don't want to have to waste my time having a fucking fight with you. If possible, I want to just, you know, absorb you into my kingdom. So that all of the High Elves work for me. And me specifically.
There is glory to be won.
Folly of Youth, Young Prince. Again, I think I've done this before. Privately chide him. Recruitment cost. I'm not really recruiting anything for a while. Also, my income's back up by like 700, and I have no idea how that happened, but sure. I'll not look that particular gift horse in the mouth. Thanks, if I can avoid it.
I am ready to fight.
Again, it says that's going to be an issue. Okay. That'd be why. He's taken that fucking port. Right, you know what? If you're going to do this, just take their entire territory, mate. Just get rid of them. I've got remarkably little interest in them at this stage. If I'm blunt, you can have it.
There is glory.
Okay, now I know this is going to make it a bit of a long video, but yeah, I want this dealt with. So we're going in. We're going in, lads. We're going in. We're going in with my new fancy white lions to take Vol's Anvil again. And then we're probably going to have to bring fucking Jalen back, because we're definitely going to end up at war with with the other faction that controls this province. Because I want this province. It's just my thing. I don't like having split provinces when there's a province system. Don't like it. I like being a blob. Do you know what I mean? I don't like... I think I've heard the term border gore for it before, where like the borders are just kind of awkward and weird, and it just doesn't look nice. That's how I don't like border gore. I like having complete control of my borders. You know what I mean? It is weird saying that, because it's hard to hear I like having full control of my borders without my brain going somewhere political with it. Do you know what I mean? It's like a little bit awkward. Come on. I want to use my new axe, boys. I had shiny stick boys. I've got shiny flying stick boys. I've got shiny mounted stick boys. I've got fucking budgie. I've got burning budgie boy. And I've got fucking big shiny throwy stick boys. But now I've got shiny axe boys. And I want to give them a go. Okay. Okay, right. So. I'm saying this right now, right? Yeah, okay, so White Lion.
Acknowledged. Heir of Anarion.
F- fuck it, there you go. That's one bunch. Let's actually have a look at them. Oh, they are lovely, aren't they? They are very nice to look at. With the actual white lions on them. Oh, they are very spiffy indeed, aren't they? The white lions of Shrace or whatever the fuck they are. Yeah, they are very spiffy. Okay, that's also... Okay, got you that. Army 1. Army 2. Although, really, I want you kind of more like that. There we go. Yep. Get you. Put you there. Send a bunch of spearmen. There is actually a very good reason why I'm sending the spearmen out behind the battering ram, because this is how... Because we are going to have to... They have cavalry. We're going to have to face it. And spearmen walking through a front gate is a pretty good answer to cavalry. Just is. Yeah, we'll get our... Yeah, fuck it. We're going to fucking send you guys forward anyway, so we'll send you guys there. We'll hide our cavalry until we need them. Yep, have our Phoenix and our Great Eagle, which I think have... I think they've got the same skeleton looking at them, so I think they've actually got the same animation, so we'll put those guys there. And we'll, yeah, there you are. Cool! Okay, let's send you out there. Actually, what we'll do... Send you two out to that side. And you to that to that side, explicitly, so you don't like weird. So you guys don't like. Yeah, explicitly, so you guys don't like. What the fuck? Just go there. So you guys don't get weird. Okay. Now we need to send. Where are you actually? Okay, so you're there. So we're gonna put you there. Gonna put you there. And yeah, send you up the other side, and you there, and you there. And everyone else just do whatever the fuck they feel like. Actually, I'll tell you what I'm going to do, because they don't really have... I'm going to send those two, my Eagle and my Phoenix. Actually, no, I'm not going to send them anywhere just yet. I don't really have a need for them right now. Especially not the, although, actually, I've got one very specific thing I'm going to send the Phoenix out to do. Like, one very specific thing that I need him to do. E-fucking-mediately. Fuck it, drink your potion of toughness. Okay, good, you are actually going to start firing. Because if you were just going to stand there, we were going to have fucking words, mate. They are actually ignoring the eagle. That, the fuck it, not the phoenix. That is pretty funny. It's also going to end badly for them when said phoenix turns right the fuck round. And does that, yeah. Right, out you go. You know what, fuck it. If they're just going to ignore them if I put them over there, I will actually just fucking go hide the phoenixes or my flying units elsewhere for now. Okay, cool. So there goes our white lions out onto the walls, and yep, it looks like they are fucking the spearmen. Like, it looks like they are actually just fucking ruining them. What's going on here? Oh, you're hitting the Lothan Sea Guard. Good lads. And yeah, also looks like they are being fucked as well. Yeah, it looks like they're not. Looks like shit ain't going well for the enemies of the White Lions of Shrace, because the White Lions of Shrace are good at chewing through armored infantry, ain't they? Really? That's the long and short of it. Yeah, it's long and short of it. You know what, fuck it, actually, you guys go deal with these other spearmen that are just kind of running around. Just, fuck it, yeah, you deal with them. These guys are fine, these spearmen are fine, they've got their enemy. Actually, what I'm gonna do is just give them a bit of a helping hand.
Acknowledge. Orders understood. For duty to the fray.
For the king.
Following orders.
Whoops. Back up there, lads. Back up on the wall.
Champion of Alaria. White Lions.
There we go. That should balance. That looks like that balances it out quite nicely. Right, lads, turn around. Go deal with these guys who are literally just kind of largely standing there, not getting much done. I don't know what their job here is today, but they seem to think they have one.
It will be done. To victory.
Yeah, they seem to they don't seem to understand that they didn't seem to understand that they were being besieged from that direction, honestly. Yeah, they really just didn't seem to get that they were under attack. Yeah, I suppose sometimes it can be hard to tell whether or not you're under attack, whether or not people are just being faintly dickish about you. Yeah, just quickly debuff everyone around Tyrion. It's fine. It's not going to present. That doesn't present any issues for them. It'll be. It as the phrase goes, it'll be reet. Ah, do you really want to attack the White Lion? Yeah, look. I just fucking saw one of you get knocked like 3 miles out of where you're supposed to be. Like, it's really not. It's not a great plan, honestly.
It shall be done. Sail! Spearmen, acknowledge.
Right, okay, we need to try and get the spearmen to fucking rush and engage the Silver Helms before. Okay, good, we managed to pull the spearmen out of that fight. I genuinely actually don't even know what to do with you. You know what? Fucking send you over there. Might as well. We got like fucking nowhere else to fucking put you, have we? Now, spearmen, stop fighting other groups and go fight the fucking horses. You have one job, spearmen. Literally one role in the military, and you are currently largely ignoring it. I don't know why you're largely ignoring it, but you're currently largely ignoring it. Let's quickly buff debuff there again. It's just, hi, how you doing? Yeah, you're not doing well, are you? Odd that you're still fighting me, though. Odd that you were still fighting Tyrion. That was impressive, if nothing else. And as much as I would like to watch, okay, well, I watched this guy get one kill. This guy here, Barrington. No, Barrington didn't get one kill. Come on, I want to see one White Lion kill one of these guys. There we go. Fucking close enough. Okay. I think that's it for that faction. How are we doing? And the Jesus fucking wept. God, White Lions of Trace. These guys are... Trace? I don't fucking know. What I do know is that I love these guys. These guys are fantastic. I like the High Elves. I've decided this now. I like the High Elves. They've got some fun units. Their thing with archers is quite good. It's reminding me a bit of when I used to play Towa Shogun 2. My clan of choice was always the Chusakabe clan because they had really good archers. So it's just... I know that doesn't sound like it's related to that, but like playing the High Elves is reminiscent of that because they've got pretty good archers, and archery is just good. Though it's something that genuinely I ignored for the longest time when I played Total War games when I was younger. I basically, my response was always, oh, just, I want really heavy infantry. That was always what I went for. Like, essentially, exclusively, I would bring heavy infantry to every single fight. Couldn't tell you why. Just thought they were better. Still kind of do. Like, I still kind of think that heavy infantry is the best response to literally every situation. Which is why almost all of my kind of end game armies are, and no matter what race I'm playing, if they have good heavy infantry, all of my end game armies for them will be composed of like 90% heavy infantry. Right.
This place is ours.
We're just going to occupy it. We don't need to be ridiculous. We've got our infantry, we've got some more of these way fragments. We got some more money in the treasury. We'll construct a Shrine of Assyrian. We've destroyed those enemies. It's fine. Oh, fantastic. And we can immediately level it up. Oh, beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you, friend. Right. I don't want that right now. Oh, fuck. It will block it. Oh, I'm torn. Because that's good. Because these are just really good. Like, these are really good bonus. These are just two very good choices here. Like, a lot of extra melee attack. Big bonus to large. Causes fear. Hit point reduction. Ugh, that's... Fuck it. Bloodline of an Aryan. I'm a warrior, not a diplomat. I'm so sorry, world. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Defender of the Phoenix Throne. Anchors away.
Okay, for a second there, he was a horse on water, and that just actually was disturbing me.
Their skill is legend.
I was just like, really? It was really frightening me. Really frightening me, that was. Militia master. Okay. Where's the other guy? Where is he?
Can I offer
a master, he's got his sea legs.
Across the waves.
Cool. So, okay, that's nice. Okay. He's better at dealing with the ocean. Cool. No, makes sense. You guys, what do you call it? The Kingdom of Nargai. Nagathi.
What would you have of me? You are no friend of the Asura of Ulthuan.
No one is your ally. I won't declare war on you just yet. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to declare war on them once. Once Tyrion is nice and healed up. Once his army's nice and healed up. What I'm going to do for now is... Increase that, get more money coming in. Yeah. Beyond that, I don't think there's much for me to do at the moment. So, I'm gonna do... End that turn. Get through this, this turn order here. Come on. Okay. And that is going to be all for me for now. I've been your humble narrator, Uncle Sideways, and, well, bye. Is it done?
Okay, cool. So I'm just gonna quickly tell you about some links in the description. Not gonna take up too much of your time because you've probably got other things to do and other videos to watch. So in the description there, you're gonna find a link to my Patreon if you want to support the channel, support me. Feel free to click that link and help me out down there. You'll also find a link to my Discord server where I talk a lot of bullshit and occasionally play games with folk. So maybe go down there, follow, join that Discord. Let's have a chat, you guys. Let's have a bit of an old chin wag. And you'll also find my Twitter, where I occasionally post dumb things. I think that's about it. Yeah, so I'm gonna go away now. Bye.